That love with just write it down. 2 cents.
I'm sorry, write it down. Romans 8, verse 5.
Joseph Valerie.
6 and 7. Romans 8, verse 5, 6 and 7. Let me continue in this vein. And it's interesting because the system doesn't care about it. When I talk about the system, I'm talking about the world system.
That's
they
right.
care about their own.
Right.
And you see, that's what Jesus said right here. When you look at it, now, my interpretation, maybe perhaps it's wrong, but as I see it, he says here that they take care of their own pretty much. But strangers, those that are outside, So therefore, let's take care of this, lest we get them upset. The system doesn't care about you or I. You must care about yourself. Hear me now. You must care about yourself and do the right thing. What's the right thing? Is to seek Him. Doing the right thing is to stay connected to Him. Doing the right thing is to be awake and take heed of what's going on around us. Be discerning. Do the right thing and trust Him. And when we do the right thing, we'll thrive in this system.
Exactly.
I say it again. The system doesn't care about you. The world system in which we live, it does not care about you and I. The system, listen, the world system, those that lead, their philosophy is trust in the government. The government will take care of you from the cradle to the grave. They'll take care of you. Nobody can do that but the Lord Jesus. He's the only one. Nobody. So to take that mentality and to put our trust in a world that's failing, a world that the scripture says is passing away, is foolish. It's foolish. But yet, in order to thrive in the system, we've got to trust in the Lord. In order to trust in the Lord, we have to have a heart of faith. Sometimes we don't feel like it. Sometimes it don't look like it's working in our favor. We've got to see beyond the surface.
That's right.
And press into the Spirit. While we look not at the things that are seen, but at the things that are unseen. Well, the things that are seen are temporary. The things that are unseen are eternal.
That's right.
What does that mean? That means your circumstance, the trials, the testings that we go through on a daily basis, they're subject to change. At any moment, it can change. Amen. So the system will take care of its own. That's what Jesus said. He says they'll take care of their own. Right? But God will take care of you and I. He's not a deadbeat daddy. He takes care of his own.
Hello.
Proverbs chapter number 3, we know it very well. Verses 5 and 6 tells us to trust in the Lord with all of our heart. Don't lean to our own understanding. He'll direct our path. Amen. Isaiah 119 tells us if we're willing and obedient, we'll eat the good of the land.
That's right.
Verse 20 says, but if we refuse and rebel, we'll be devoured.
There you go.
Huh? So in order to thrive in the system in which we live, we must do the right thing.
Right.
Doing the right thing is trusting in the Lord. In order to thrive in the system in which we live, we must care about yourself.
Thank you.
Now, preacher, that sounds pretty selfish. No, it's not. In order for you to be what God's called you to be, you need to take care of you.
Thank you.
And if you don't, there'll be a problem. Look at Psalms 37. Verse number 5 tells us this. Jesus says, Psalms 37, verse 25, Jesus said this. But David said this. He says, I've been young, and now I'm old. But I've not seen the righteous forsaken,
nor seed begging bread. That's right.
Psalms 37, verse 25, again. He says, I've been young, and now I'm old. Yet I've not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. In other words, what does that mean? He'll take care of you. He'll take care of you. David said, I've lived all this life, and I've not seen God forsaken. He takes care of his own. Just like the world will take care of their own. Amen? Now, go back over to Matthew. I know, you've been there. Let's go back there again. Matthew 17. Go back there. I know you've been there. I'm almost finished. Man, I have a whole lot more. We could be here another 3 hours, Troy. I won't do that to you. I might have to come over to the house. If you do, bring some food. All right? But look at what he says, Matthew 17. Matthew 17, verse number, again, back at verse number 24. He says this now. Well, just look at verse number 27. Nevertheless, lest we offend them, go to the sea, cast in a hook, and take a fish that comes up, the first fish that comes up. And when you have opened its mouth, you will find a piece of money. Take it and give it to them for you and me. Again, example of God providing for his own. Taking care of us. Peter didn't reason this thing away. Peter trusted in the Lord. He moved with faith. He didn't reason it. Second Corinthians chapter number 10. Verses number 3-6, it talks about reasoning away, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. And in the time in which we're living, hearing all the things that are happening, not only in our nation, but all over the world, compare those things to what God's word is saying. Prove them out in Scripture.
Right.
And the final authority is the Scripture. The final authority is what God has said.
Amen.
If you find your mind dwindling, or not dwindling, oh, you don't want your mind to move. If you find your mind going off in an area where you began to get into unbelief, draw it back into what God's word.
Right.
Casting down imaginations. Don't you know, with this mind, don't you know, we have the ability to think about what we're thinking.